Hello friends, today's chapter is Properties of Pure Substance. Let us define what is pure substance. The substances that are homogeneous in chemical composition homogeneous in chemical composition means the chemical properties or the chemical composition of the substances will not change if their state will change. Just for example, take water, H2O. It is the chemical formula of water. Now, water in liquid state will also have H2O, in vapor state will also have the chemical formula as H2O, and in the ice form it will also have the chemical formula as H2O. So the state is changing but the chemical formula is not changing. This chemical composition is not changing. So water is a pure substance. This is the definition of the pure substance. Before going further deep in this chapter, we should know some definition, and the first one is saturation temperature. For every liquid, a liquid boils at a particular temperature for given corresponding particular pressure. That temperature is called saturation temperature, and the pressure at which it is boiling is known as saturation pressure. Then this pressure is called the saturation pressure, and the temperature corresponding to this pressure is known as saturation temperature. As I told you above, that water, that means H2O, is an example of pure substance. So let's try to study the nature or the variation of pressure with respect to temperature of water. This graph shows the variation of pressure with temperature of water. This line is known as sublimation line, while this line is known as vaporization line, and this line is known as fusion line. Between sublimation line and the fusion line, the solid state exists, and between the sublimation line and the vaporization line, the vapor phase exists, and between the fusion line and the vaporization line, the liquid phase of the water exists. Now in this graph you can see there is an intersection of three lines coming at one point. This intersection point has a temperature. This is known as critical temperature, and this point is known as the triple point. Hence, the triple point is defined as the point where all the three phases of water or pure substance exist. Here you can see at this point liquid phase also exists, vapor phase also exists, as well as the solid phase. That is why it is known as the triple point, and the temperature corresponding to triple point is known as critical temperature. If we name the line as O, A, B and C, the line OA represents sublimation line. The line AB represents vaporization line. While the line AC represents fusion line. The next is TS nature of the pure substance. where T is temperature and S is entropy. Here is a graph that shows the nature or the variation of pure substance between temperature and entropy plotted at constant pressure. As the temperature increases, the entropy will increase, but after a certain point, the temperature remains constant while the entropy increases, and then after that, when entropy increases, temperature also increases. So we get points A, B, C, D, and E. There are several points on this graph, and these points are defined as point A is defined as subcooled state. That means the initial point. Point B is defined as saturated liquid state. That is the point at from which the liquid will start changing into vapor. Up to this phase, the substance is in liquid state. Between B to D, it is liquid plus vapor, and after point D, it is totally vapor. So, point C is defined as liquid plus vapor state. Point D is defined as dry saturated state. While point E is defined as super heat state. Point A is subcooled state, that is the initial state of the liquid changing to vapor. Point B is the saturated liquid state, that is the point from where the liquid will start changing into vapor. Point C is liquid plus vapor state, that is at this phase the liquid and vapor coexist. Point D is dry saturated vapor state, that means the point from which the liquid completely transforms into vapor. And point E is the superheat state, that is the final state of the vapor. The temperature at B is equals to temperature at C is equals to temperature at D is known as the saturation temperature. The heat between B to D is known as latent heat. If you draw the TS curve for several pressures, that means P1, P2 and P3, we will get the graph like this. At P1 it will be like this, at P2 like this, and P3 like this. Joining all these points, we will get a dome like shape. This part is known as saturated vapor line, while this part is known as saturated liquid line. So, saturated vapor line is the locus of all dry saturated vapor state, while saturated liquid line is the locus of all saturated liquid state. The point C, that is the peak point of the dome, is known as critical point. That is, beyond this point, the latent heat will be zero. That means the liquid will directly change into vapor without going into liquid plus vapor state. This phase is the liquid phase. This phase is liquid plus vapor phase, while this phase is fully vapor phase. So beyond critical point, the liquid directly changes to vapor without going to liquid plus vapor phase. The next topic is dryness fraction. It is denoted by small x and defined as the amount of dry steam present in total amount of wet steam, that is x is equals to mv by ml plus mv, where m is the mass of dry vapor, ml is the mass of liquid, or wet vapor. Clearly, with the definition, you may have understood that x or dryness fraction can only be defined between this zone, that is inside this dome. This dome is known as vapor dome, because inside this dome only the liquid as well as the vapor phase exist. So at the starting point, it is all liquid. That means the x value is zero, because there is no dry vapor is present, the mass of the vapor is zero. And at the right side, the all substance is converted into vapor. That means the x is equal to 1. That means the vapor mass is totally equal to the liquid. The liquid mass will be 0. So the vapor mass is the total mass of the steam. So the x is equal to 1. Between these x equal to 0 and x equal to 1, the dryness fraction varies inside this dome. Now consider the TS diagram once again. Here we will know some important relation while calculating the dryness fraction. The end point on the right hand side of the dome is represented by F, while the left hand side is represented by G. So between these two, entropy is represented by SFG, which is equals to SF minus SG. Similarly, if on the x-axis we have enthalpy, then HFG, that will be equal to HF minus HG. Similarly, for volume, VFG will be equal to VF minus VG. If we need to find out the value of entropy or enthalpy between or inside this dome, we use the relation. Suppose writing for entropy, it will be Sx is equals to Sg plus x Sfg. For enthalpy, it will be Hx is equals to Hg plus x Hfg. The values of SFG, HFG will be calculated through the steam table. The next is P PV nature of the pure substance, that is pressure volume nature. So far we learned PT and the TS nature of the pure substance. Now the PV nature of the pure substance. Here the dome is shifting more towards the right side and it is drawn at the constant temperature, and notice the difference that the pressure is decreasing in nature, that means it is coming from up to down, and the shape of the dome is slightly changed on the right hand side. Left hand side is quite similar, while on the right hand side it is more shifting towards the right side more. So this is the nature of the pressure volume curve of the pure substance. The next is HS curve, that means enthalpy versus entropy curve. This is also known as Mollier's chart. The dome here is having shape like this. It is drawn at the constant temperature line, which is shown here, and the constant pressure line, which is shown here. Now the dryness fraction changes from here x equal to 0 to x equal to 1. For example, in this diagram it has shown the dryness fraction line of x equal to 0.8. Here it is shown x equal to 0.9. Now this diagram is very important to find out the value of enthalpy or the entropy for a specific given temperature and pressure. Suppose the temperature is given, considered 220 degrees Celsius, and the pressure is given as 5 bar. So considering the 5 bar line and 220 degrees Celsius line, plotting the intersection point, the corresponding x axis will give the corresponding entropy, and on the y axis it will give the value of the enthalpy. Similarly, suppose if the temperature is not given and the pressure value is given, but instead of temperature, dryness fraction value is given. So consider example of pressure as 5 bar, dryness fraction as 0.8. The 5 bar line and dryness fraction 0.8, considering the intersection point, corresponding x axis gives the value of the entropy, corresponding y axis gives the value of enthalpy. So that is how the Mollier's chart is used to find the value of enthalpy and the entropy using the value of pressure, dryness fraction, or pressure and temperature. So that's all for properties of pure substance. See you in the next video. Thank you.